My name is Robert, and I'm from Gilbert, Arizona. I brought this group of journalists together because I think there needs to be somebody disrupting the mainstream media. I'm not a journalist, I'm an entrepreneur.
My name is Justin King from Destin, Florida. I think civilized debate in the U.S. is possible if we leave the politicians and corporate media out of it.
My name is Nick Bernabe. I'm from San Diego, California. What I want to change about the news is I want everybody to have a voice. I want to shine the camera on the people that don't ever get any attention.
I'm Ford Fischer. I'm from Washington, D.C. The mainstream media tends to focus on what Trump tweeted while he was on the toilet this morning. I really want all of society to realize that there are more options.
My name is Carey Wedler, and I am from Los Angeles, California. These days, it's very easy for people to pick and choose their realities, but I actually care about what's going on, and I care about things being reported factually.
My name is Derrick Broze, and I'm from Houston, Texas. We're not trying to step into the role to be the new mainstream media. We're trying to encourage a whole new generation of independent journalists all around the world.
Good morning, guys. Here we are. We're in Los Angeles this morning for the Women's March.
You know, it's already trending on Twitter, and we've got a few interviews lined up.
The group we've assembled here are some of the best independent journalists in the industry. Everyone on the team has different points of view.
Growing up, I was just a regular kid, skateboarding, BMXing. The first news story that really made an impact on me was the terrorist attacks of 9/11. That's really what drove me to start to question, why do things like this happen in the world?
How are we gonna go about getting some of these interviews from these people?
Hunting them down.
Hunting them down. And you guys are gonna be on Twitter. When you see anybody that's on our hit list,
yep,
tell us where they're at.
My history has definitely influenced my work. I was a military contractor. My skills were shooting a gun and gathering information. You took away the gun and I was a journalist.
Congress can't come to an agreement when it comes to immigration, but they can agree on things like FISA and surveillance.
Growing up, I went through a phase of using drugs and being addicted to drugs, and then finding myself in prison for 18 months. That was the origin of what made me change the direction I was headed in.
We're gonna each have a different approach, but we're gonna kind of combine it into one live stream interview slash confrontation. From a young age, I was always on the libertarian end of the spectrum. I've interned at Fox News, and the first story that intrigued my skepticism of the mainstream media would be the invasion of Iraq. We were told that it was something patriotic, and then we kind of found out that the premise of that war was false.
And I'm gonna be trying to track down the executive director for the ACLU. I was a hardcore Democrat. I had very enthusiastically supported Barack Obama, but I think it's about time to burn your shirt. The defining moment for me was that he had appointed financial insiders and continued the wars in the Middle East. And it sort of made me pause and think that maybe there was something that wasn't quite right.
Let's do it, let's figure it out.
Let's go on, guys, let's do it.
Let's go.
Cool.
Each of us has our own perspectives and we're gonna work it on different angles. Hey, what's up everyone? This is Derrick. I'm here in LA at the Women's March 2018.
All right, we're just starting to gather. They've got pussy hats, seeing lots of signs, and I have lots of questions.
We're gonna have four journalists out in the field trying to get interviews, getting footage, and Robert and I are here tracking hashtags and helping gather the information, disseminating it, and hoping that we can get a lot of people to see it.
How you guys doing out there?
We're good.
We're setting up for that live stream now. In order to get my content out, I'm live streaming it and people can watch it exactly as it's happening. What else can women be doing other than voting?
We have to be defending healthcare access and women's rights because this administration is hell-bent on taking away everything we fought for.
We got Cecile Richards, president of Planned Parenthood. That's big.
Ford's live stream already has almost 5,000 views.
The comments are outrageous. My commenters believe that this march is led by the rulers of evil. I have a little bit of a right-wing following in some cases.
You can see behind me, there's Trump supporters and people against Trump screaming at each other like children across the street. This is such a waste of time.
So what overall do you think of this event?
We're not here for your photo ops. We're not here for you to make it appear that black women were included in this event.
Thank you guys.
Our live stream isn't working.
Oh no, when did that happen?
Throughout the whole thing.
When you're an independent journalist, you often end up with jammed cell phones, and sometimes the police use equipment to jam cell phones.
I see the struggles that the independent media goes through and what they're really up against. It would further their goals if they could only have more resources, if they could only have more access.
So my usual routine is just walk in wherever I can until somebody tells me no.
Have you seen any speakers here today that really resonate
hey,
with you?
I can't have nobody standing behind the stage.
If you could leave this area.
We have to escort you.
Okay, we'll go, come on. Derrick, Jesus fucking Christ.
Justin and Nick, Justin and Robert.
Are you trying to call us?
We officially got kicked out.
We get treated like shit everywhere, dude.
It's what we deal with as indie media. We've all dealt with it in different ways.
It is what it is. It's part of the fight.
On that point, Robert, what do you think we got on our hands today, man?
We did get a tip just last night that there is a protest over at the Mandalay Bay.
We are heading to Mandalay Bay.
The scene of essentially the largest mass shooting in American history.
Conspiracy theorists are out on the street.
We're gonna go talk to them.
So you're saying terrorism, right? And that it wasn't a single shooter.
Who are you really?
No.
I've gotten nothing but a very bad vibe from you.
Bad vibe?
It feels to me very strongly that you're against our agenda here.
I'm a very direct person. My best friends say I'm an asshole.
If you're just waking up, I know your vision is blurred, and you're still making the decision to dismiss what you've heard. You have to give it up. This shit is absurd, and if you never ask the questions and answers can't be preserved.
This group of journalists is really diverse. We don't always get along.
Everything's good.
We're live?
We're live.
How's it going?
Across all of us, we have different ideologies. We act as kind of a check and balance on each other's language.
So Hillary didn't get elected. You didn't get what you wanted. It seems like voting didn't work.
You can't torture people that long. That's not fair.
That's where that debate comes from. We battle it out so the readers get the full story.
You know, it is this like left-right dichotomy, and it's the donkey versus the elephant. It's like the red and the blue. It's this like smackdown. I love working with Justin, Nick, Derrick, and should I say Ford? I love working with Justin, Nick, Derrick, and Ford. They're people I really respect.
And I think that there's a lot of common ground about what the problem is and how to solve it.
For me, it's a chance to kind of poke the bear and see if we can get people to search for solutions rather than slogans.
Hey, let him up, let him up.
Getting in the shit, so to speak, that is my comfort zone.
This is really about me saying, hey, you guys are good at what you do. I want to get you out there, and I want to see what kind of value can we bring to people that are really looking for this kind of information.
Maybe someday some kids are going to come up and knock us for being too mainstream.
I'm here in Standing Rock, site of the fight against the Dakota Access Pipeline.
I like to go to the places where people are confronting power directly because I'm a curious person. I want to know the truth about the world.
Don't touch me. I'm with the press.
I love being a woman in this environment. I have such an empowered opportunity to speak to so many people and also to challenge their viewpoints.
Hail Trump.
Hail Trump. So where does that come from? No, is that a Nazi reference?
No.
Hail Hitler. Hail Trump. Hitler? Ah. Thanks for your time.
He's trolling. I think he's a little confused.
Yeah, we have a White House press pass. From truth comes reason, from reason comes liberty. I think that in the long term, a more objective media will lead to more liberty.
The right-wingers are permitted to be up in the park, which is up in this direction.
I try to use my platform not to tell people what they should think, but I try to use my platform to tell people you need to start thinking.